from within. See to it that no one takes you captive through hollow and deceptive philosophy, which depends on human tradition and the elemental spiritual forces of this world rather than on Christ. Isaiah was right when he prophesied about you hypocrites, as it is written, though these people honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. They worship me in vain. Their teachings are merely human rules. You have let go of the commands of God and are holding on the human tradition. Heavenly Father God, I know your word is the truth. If there is something in my life based on human tradition that takes away from my devotion to Christ, make it apparent so I can ask for forgiveness and reroute my attentions. Amen. Finding your roots. This is what the Lord says. Cursed is the one who trusts in man, who draws strength from mere flesh, and whose heart turns away from the Lord. That person will be like a bush in the wastelands. They will not see prosperity when it comes. They will dwell in the parched places of the desert, in a salt and where no one lives. But blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in him. They will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when heat comes. Its leaves are always green. It has no worries in fear of drought and never fails to bear fruit. Heavenly Father God, thank you for being a constant presence in my life. Your protection of my heart and spirit are total. Your strength encouraging and your sustenance refreshing. Show me how I can trust in you even more than I do now, so I can dwell in the prosperity of your spirit. Amen. What we are really looking for, gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, by the power of your spirit, use my attention, actions, and my words to clearly communicate with truth to the desperate souls today. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Raising the shield again and always. Dear Lord, many are saying of you, my soul, there is no deliverance of him in God, but you, Lord, are a shield about me, my glory, and the one who lifts my head. I am crying to you, the Lord, with my voice. You have answered me from your holy mountain. Selah. Hallelujah. Amen. Our boiling pot. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and vermin destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moths and vermin do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and still. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. No one can serve two masters. Either you will hate the one and love the other, or you will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and money. Gracious Father, I am going to need a special awareness of your grace, and I address this issue with you. Search my heart, show me my ways. By the counsel of your Spirit in me, give me the wisdom and the willingness to align my life with the truth of your word, so that I can serve you in freedom rather than serve materialism as a slave. Amen. Are you being robbed right now? The seed falling among the thorns refers to someone who hears the word, but the worries of this life and deceitfulness of wealth choke the word, making it unfruitful. Beloved Jesus, gently but firmly, show me where I have allowed money and materialism to rob me of the riches of blessings that are found only in you. By faith, for my own good, I ask that you would do whatever it takes to refocus my trust on you, to place my hope in you, to serve only you. Amen. Letting God guide your generosity. And he told them this parable. The ground of a certain rich man yielded an abundant harvest. He thought to himself, what shall I do? I have no place to store my crops. Then he said, this is what I will do. I will tear down my barns and build bigger ones, and there I will store my surplus grain. And I will say to myself, you have plenty of grain laid up for many years. Take life easy, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said to him, you fool, this very night your life will be demanded from you. Then who will get what you have prepared for yourself? This is how it will be with anyone who stores up things for himself but is not rich toward God. Then he said to them, watch out, be on your guard against all kinds of greed. Life does not consist in an abundance of possession. God of all, right here, right now, guide my thoughts. I want to be honest. I need you to make me want to be obedient. I need your Spirit to show me how I am yours. Everything in my possession is yours. Show me the next step of generosity you want me to take with your stuff right now. Then show me the next step, then the next, then. Amen, hallelujah, amen.